I've begun to think of life as a collection of stories and people as characters, which is why I thought it would be best to try to conclude this part of my life before the next starts. When change comes, it's usually uncalled for. Usually you don't know when it happens, but still, in stories, before things end or another act starts, conflicts tend to get resolved. And people say sorry, and friends come to the sad but obvious realization that their relationship won't look like it used to. Of course, for some storylines, it doesn't work that way. They sort of just lay there, hanging, giving us the little hope that we need. It's a clever plot device, in my opinion. You're always wondering, anticipating if the two characters would ever reconcile or if that kid would really become a pilot. Loose ends. They make you hope that there will be a reunion, and ultimately they make you hope that things will be okay, that they'll go well, and that we'll at least through this story get the satisfying conclusion that we never got from our own storylines. It's probably a very filmy and naive way to think about things. But in the words of a friend, it still kind of makes sense. Or maybe that's just because, like me, my friend also thinks of life as a collection of stories and people as characters. Or maybe that's because when we begin to look at the past, at friendships, life events and whatnot, the way we remember and recall them is primarily through a narrative. The gaps between events and the way people acted, bridged by reasons. Reasons we could come up with for them at the time. Because somehow it needs to not just be random. It needs to make some sense. All of this concludes in a very vivid story that was and is still being narrated by your own internal monologue. And every time I remember why a friendship ended abruptly or why I stopped visiting that particular shop for filter coffee, my current internal monologue interrupts and adds something. There's always a new comment like, hey, that friendship clearly had a timer attached to it, or a discovery. That shop's filter coffee stopped tasting nice because you didn't have a friend to share it with. Each time I share the story with someone, it changes ever so slightly. Just like how Bua kept changing her bedtime stories every day, building upon the one that she had just said yesterday night and turning it into something that was almost like the one that she was saying last night, but oddly, not quite. Back to my point though, I've been trying to conclude things for now. Friendships, storylines, conversations with people, with the sole aim of avoiding things to be just left hanging in the air. So that there aren't any friendships that just randomly faded or ended abruptly because I shifted to another city thousands of kilometers away. I'm trying to make it a point to meet up with friends and fill in gaps of experiences. I'm trying to finish up paintings and books because I'm petrified that if I leave them incomplete, if I never finish them, they will never be finished. It's a sad thought to even think about. Maybe I haven't grown up enough to accept the fact that not all stories end and that you have to live life with some bittersweet memories, or maybe I am naive enough to believe that I can actually conclude friendships or aspects of my life before another chapter begins. But I'd like to think that in some way I'll be able to do justice to this story that I am currently a part of before I become a part of another one.